get up in the morning, look at my clock. It's way past noon time and I'm late for work. Tell me, what if I done run? Let him go ride with me, must be I've been smoking too long. Try to make me some breakfast, but I ain't got no food. Try to take a shower, but the water don't feel no good. Tell me, what if I done wrong? And nothing go right with me, must be I've been smoking too long. Got opium in my children, no other life to choose. Nightmares made of hash dreams and the devil on my shoes. Tell me, what if I done wrong? And nothing go right with me, must be I've been smoking too long.
Shit.
When I'm out smoking, I put my worries on the shelf. Try to think about nothing and not see myself. Tell me, what if I don't want nothing to love with me? Must be I've been smoking too long. And in this blue sun,
hello, Melly.
Hi.
What do you think of my new ridiculous television?
I love it.
Yeah?
It's not that new. You've had it since August.
Yeah, I suppose. But
no, I still love it.
Yeah.
Loved it back then, still love it now.
So. But you still don't want a TV in your house?
No.
No. So it's good for me, but you know, that's how the plebs live, and you're above us all with your TV free lifestyle.
I just don't like having stuff.
Yeah. Okay, well, fine, whatever. All right, continuing the list of things Melly does not have. Ah, yeah, a covered patio. So this is 1/3 of the total length. Obviously, this is gonna get cut back and we're gonna have a end piece that gets on here and gives me a nice hand grab and also allows me to catch the rain, which will make water collection a little bit easier. So we got the second section done with the beams. They're all in place. This last one has to be glued. And then we have to do two more. So it's gonna go out a little bit, and I'm playing around with it. I think I'm gonna make it full length and then we're gonna see how it performs. If it's too long, I can always cut it down. So, but that's part of the math equation. If you want enough solar power to actually move this boat around, well, you need a lot of solar panels. So in order to get enough solar panels, we need a lot of bimini and a lot of surface area to cover in that. Well, I for one am really excited to have a closed in section back here where the sawdust can just brush away and stay clean, and where I can be sheltered from the wind and work all winter long out here and keep my interior space nice and clean and clear. Very excited for that. Hey Melly, is this going to replace your Harley?
You want to talk about it?
Tell the people.
All right, YouTube, I'm selling my Harley Davidson. Well, I'm not in a rush, but it's up for sale. Maybe Simon, you could put the ad on Craigslist. You can put it below the video.
And what's it going to fund? Is it going to fund a classic Ford pickup truck or what?
No, it's going to fund another motorcycle. I am looking for a Kawasaki Ninja, so I'm going to be a Kawasaki girl again.
Yeah, but you want to go, you're thinking of going retro like mine, eh?
Yeah, I'm looking 80s. For a 90s, maybe 80s, but looking for a 90s, 2000s 600 Ninja.
So it looks like, at least while I still have a fossil fuel, that'll be my last fossil fuel vehicle probably, but we're going to be a classic crotch rocket crew.
Yeah.
Which is better than like, I mean, I love all motorcycles, don't get me wrong, I really do. And I love that Harley a lot more than I thought I would. Having gotten to ride it down to Los Angeles with you, and there was like some good chunks where I got to ride it, which was a lot of fun. But yeah, I'm really falling in love with the crotch rocket life. A whole big world that you and I don't know that much about.
No, I'm looking for the one that's not meant for the racetrack, obviously, a street bike, so.
And that is the wrong decision, but you know, you're entitled to it.
I mean, I don't know if you want to talk about that too, but we plan on maybe visiting a racetrack and getting a track
yes,
day in.
Yes, we're going to get some track days in.
Yep.
And if we're going to get track days in, I ain't rolling with no girl with just two cylinders. Come on, okay. Four cylinders. Let's do it. Commit.
All right.
Yeah, four cylinders. I mean, she's a bit of a fixer-upper. There's only one little store or shop here on the south end of Gabriola, and it's basically a little tourist, like a resort. Resort's a strong word, it's campground. But it's on the water and it's quite nice and it's right near our boat, so we just walked around and picked up the latest copy of our new Folk Life magazine, where I've got a little feature in there. All right, well, this is really cool. Look at that. The plan is for it to still go out another 4 whole feet. So it's gonna hang over the transom. I don't know, like it already looks huge. So if it hangs out 4 more feet, then I have more bimini than I need. So what I might end up doing is getting it to hang 2 more feet and then having the solar panels just hang a little bit off the ends. And we'll see if that works. But I think what I'll do right now is I'll just build it out to be 4 more feet. We'll test everything, and then I can easily just chop 2 feet off. A lot easier than adding another 2 feet and it still being structurally sound. So that's the plan, we're gonna stick to it. We're gonna do 12 feet, and then we might cut 2 feet off, and it'll just be 10 foot plus a few inches of extra solar panel. It's a lot. But it's necessary in order to get enough power to actually move this boat reliably. And we don't have very reliable power right now. You can hear my neighbor with his generator, but me, it's out here, it's 8 panels is barely holding up. 16 panels do me a lot better, but really some wind turbines, that's what I really want up here. So we'll get the wind turbines up here soon. Stick with me on that one. It's coming really soon. Well, are you warm enough in here, honey? You enjoying nice warm? Good times by the wood stove? You know, cozy. Sunsets at 4 p.m. up here in the north, so, you know, we're doing work with flashlights, but there's only so much work with flashlights we can really do. I mean, we're doing some programming work, some electrical work, some finishing work indoors, but there's also a lot of time for relaxing in the wintertime, which I'm very much looking forward to. All right, well, we slept. Still looks like night because Canada, but we're heading off to Cortez today. We're gonna spend the weekend up there visiting some friends and getting even further out into the wilderness. It's beautiful up there, so let's go do this. Finally got picked up by the ferry. It's been, we waited what, like
two hours
a bit, not too bad. There's a pretty good swell out there. The wind has died down, but the waves have not. So the ferry's going a bit slow. Wow.
Oh my god.
It's just like being in a sailboat.
Oh my god.
But we're
god,
in a truck right now.
No, I'm really scared.
We'll be fine. Hey, don't worry. We strapped a lifeboat to the back of the truck. We're good. You made it? You okay?
We made it, but it was very scary.
Oh. Well, it was supposed to be stormy all day, but I guess we got lucky. It's clearing up quite nicely. We're gonna go and get the dinghy off the back of the truck, and we got a little bit of a chore to do with the dinghy. It's cool, we're introducing these folks to boat life. Mr. Kevin, Ferraya Camino.
to give a little bit of love.
It's not a shrimp rosella.
Do they literally smell like shrimp?
They smell like fish. Maybe a western rosella. That's very red.
Is some kind of bolete. I don't know if it's a bad slippery jack. I don't know the bolete family well enough, but.
They're just beautiful.
It does smell nice here.
Very much a wild island. There's no trails here. We were trying to follow some deer paths, but they're kind of really crappy trail makers. And I'm now in a creek swallowed by a bunch of fallen trees, and you just keep slipping off the tree branches and diving 3 feet into the mud. We'll make it down there eventually. We made it back to the main island, had a bit of an adventure. I moored the boat on the north side, and the forecast called for less than 10 kilometers of wind come out, and there's significantly more than that. So much so that the waves are now crashing on the north side of the spit and completely swamped the boat. I mean, it was totally flooded. So we bailed it and picked it and dragged it, and luckily we're on a spit, so we were able to pick it up, carry it over the spit, launch it on the north side of the spit, and or I guess it would have been the south side of the spit. And then we weren't able to go back the way we came because the waves were standing a good, you know, 3 footers and stuff out there, so, which is a lot for that little dinghy, especially with 4 people in it. So opted to go the other way. We are now moored up at the gorge, which is this cool facet of this island, how they have a giant interior saltwater lake that you can cruise into and be totally sheltered. Very nice, and it just happened to be around the corner from where we were. So we're back, we're on dry land, everything's fine. But,
we're a bit disheveled though. And
yeah, wet. Don't ever listen to a weather forecast. As I think I've said 900 times on my YouTube channel, don't. These guys don't know what they're doing.
Also, did you mention we lost the plug?
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we did lose the plug for like the third time.
I had extra socks. Oh.
shower the tone, skin in, stiga hagen, dansa tjärnin. Och medan parken ser vi, och fännen skrytna lek, vi kvar ut skilje.
All right, well, you're not gonna believe this, but the weather today, fantastic. Yesterday, 70 kilometer an hour winds.
And
shit. Yeah, it's been, it was a good time to get off the boat. And we got back here, we had a bit of a rigmarole actually getting out to the boat because now we have the winter tide. So we've arrived past sunset, which is about 3:30 p.m. And there's a good chance we're gonna have low tides. And if there's low tides, my rear dock that I get for free at the back, well, there's a reason it's free. It dries out. So we had a little bit of a tough time getting out here, but then in the end, it was okay. Fired up the wood stove, we watched a bunch of episodes of Community, stayed warm, stayed cozy, didn't get seasick from getting tossed around too much. Everything was okay. All right, I wanna wrap up today's episode. Next episode, we're getting way into the work because I am doing a haul out, because I kinda can. Everything's been delayed. I've been working on the shipyard, like fixing the rail there, so. My haulout is now like basically a month later than it was supposed to be, but hopefully the weather cooperates. I still got a little bit of work to do. I want to get these rudders hung and a lot of other little things, so it'll be fun.
Bye-bye.
So tune in next episode and watch me suffer some more.